Relocatable code is a code, actually it is basically comes to the compiler picture, not to the interpreter picture. The, whenever the compiler compiles, you know that you don't have to have your program in a single file, that you all know. So the program can be there and the other companion files may be at different file together. Take the example of a C, main program is file1.c and other subprograms may be file2, file c.c, and then you compile this file, then the object file will be created. It will not be executable file, and this code is relocatable. That means it depends, it is a relocatable code means whenever there is any jump instruction, then it will be not absolute jump instruction, it will be index based jumps, so that if the code starts from there, from how many steps, how many words away you have to jump. So it is a all index based jump. So this kind of code is called relocatable code. So actually when you get the machine's memory space, and that is the duty of the loader and linker. The first is linker. Link will all the object files will be link it, make it a single file, and then loader file then loads the program in the main your main memory, and loader's duty is to put those relocatable address filled up with appropriate address. So that's it. It depends on machine to machine, not only machine to machine. It depends on at what time you are running the machine and what are your other programs are running. So actual code will might be changed. Definitely the jump address, if there are any jump address or any go to address, definitely go to instructions, though it is not there in C, but whenever in compiled code, there may be the alternative go to is a jump instruction. So absolute code will be put by your loader. So that is the reason all this code at the duty of the compiler is to make it a relocatable code. Exact meaning of relocatable means that you can actual code which is running on your machine, that is called process, and whatever you are writing, it is a program. Now for program, by the compiling you make it object file, then combining object file you make it a linker, then this file will be taken by a loader, and loader duty is to this relocatable address to properly fill it up. Suchishmita, got this answer, or I'll try make it clear in our next class with the examples. I've okay. Got no any doubt where any doubt what is relocatable code? So all the
sir,
yeah,
file
English because it is a recorded, Suchishmita, because it's recorded, speak in English. See,
compiler,
yeah.
So code translated into machine code by compiler, which
no,
is called
no,
object.
No, no, no. I am telling you. No. Absolutely. That is first of all, the compiler. This is the first is analysis portion, and then is the intermediate code generation. This intermediate code generation is machine independent. It is basically kinds of a code which can be run on with some modification can be run on many machine. It's kind of a code of a virtual machine. Actual machine dependent code at the last phase. Okay, so the compiler's job, major job is analysis, and this is a machine generation in two part. One part is machine independent way and another is machine dependent way. That is the thing that but in interpreter case it is different. Interpreter's case it is a line by line execution, but these phases, analysis phases are same. But interpreter is different. But I am basically we are now discussing about the compilation process. Okay. Now another question from Shubhrokanti. What's the question of Shubhrokanti? Suchishmita, can you tell? One more question.
This sir, is from Shourashish.
Shourashish has a mic problem. If you can talk in a mic, that's great. Shourashish, can you give your question, please? Shourashish, are you there, Shourashish?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, put your question.
My question was, what all things are stored in ML table? What all things are stored in the symbol table?
Yeah, actually you missed the last class and you have missed my videos also. They are everything is there. Please look at it. If you are not satisfied, then next class. Okay. In the last class video, I got all the symbol table, all language C, Java. I have shown and what should be there. It should be a collection of tables, and each it is not a single table. It is a table per scope. It is a per function, per even scope of a function. So it is a multiple tables and they are linked together. So if you see my earlier class, you see all the details. Thing is, I have told you that most of the compilers are two pass one. Have you understood? Two pass, not a single pass. So, but day by day, maybe different software techniques, we can get a compiler by a single pass. So in one pass, you will get a compile code. It's tough. So it's generally two pass or more than two pass right now. Now, question is, error can happen at any time. Okay. We have the stages here, say lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer, minimum 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, and actually more stages in between there. So error can handle at any time. But one might ask question, if I can handle error at lexical analysis, why I stopped all activities there? Or if I found the error at syntax analysis like parsing, I should stop there. Actually, it is not, because compilers generally, compiler is used by expert programmer. The programs generally say maybe 100 lines or maybe 1000 lines. So if I found only one silly error and go back, and then your compiler would not be attractive. So if the compiler has to be very user friendly and attractive, so what's the logic of compiler is, so every places they found an error, they think they can correct the error and go on. But they always inform you that that is the possible error. Probably you have seen it, the compiler issues warning. So definitely whenever you are compiling by GCC or anything, you see you must got several warnings. And we teachers sometimes say you ignore the warnings, but the errors is there, they generally stop. And sometimes they try to find out more than one errors, so that whenever you are editing the code, you can correct all the error producing code at a time. Not you have to go back and forth, back and forth. That is the part of your answer, that why the error handling should not be stopped at one phase only. The compiler will be always intelligent and always try to self-correct that error. Assume that error has been done by missing semicolon. Missing semicolon error, definitely it comes from the lexical analysis. Or if you have tried variable name with a numeric, the error comes from lexical analysis. Syntax analyzer error, if you mismatch bracket or you mismatch if then else, there's a syntax analyzer. Then semantic analyzer means whenever the error you are making a array index with a floating point number, then the semantic analyzer would come and flag the error. Intermediate code generation, generally after these three stages, there are no such error comes. So that is the thing, logic of it. And error handling is a big thing. Error handling, how the error is handled and how we report the error, that is a big thing. And there, in the last class I have told you, there are some calculation, last two class, fast and follow. Actually, the error handler takes the follow. So that is the, and the follow, benchmark, or you can say the, like semicolon. Semicolon is very, very essential in C language. So the last semicolon, we can take it, the error is handled okay. So like this, certain markers in the follow of the particular symbols will be give out to the user, so that whenever there's some error, you see in Java, C, whenever you see the error, what are the error reported, they are basically the follow terminal symbol of the follow character, and they will give out. So the error handling done at lexical analysis, syntax analysis and semantic analysis. Another thing I wish to tell, that I have told you earlier, in very few compiler, maybe lexical analysis and syntax analysis are together. But 99% compiler, they are different stage, because if I put a lexical analysis at a different stage, the lots of complexity will be less than syntax analyzer. The most complicated step definitely is syntax analyzer to understand like where we are right now today. We are right now entering into the top-down parsing, predictive top-down parsing, because we have already started top-down parsing where the backtracking is there. Backtracking is absolutely no-no in computer science and everywhere. How to avoid backtracking? No, you cannot avoid backtracking. If the grammar is like this, you have to get rid of the grammar. Then there is come left recursion. Yes, left recursion. Shohum probably asked the question. You can avoid left recursion. We will see that how to avoid left recursion, and then the grammar is converted. Then it is suitable for if it is a parsing table. We can create a parsing table. Left hand side will be all the your variables, and top side will be the terminals for every variables, and look ahead terminals, there will be one and only one rule. So if that called the parsing table, that can be handmade, that can be done by programmers. So Ankita, that's a go on and go on, but is your question is clear, or do you please if you have any doubt, please tell me.
Okay. No, sir. Now I understood.
Yeah, actually error can happen at every stages. Okay. Summarily, I am telling you. And error should not be like, error maybe with includes warning also. So, error doesn't mean error. Error includes warning. Warning, with warning the compiler can go ahead. But it is the duty of the compiler to issue the warning to the user. So, that is the reason the compiler should not stop one warning and one error, then it would be very much boring. So if there are several warnings, genuine warnings, the compiler issue it, and errors, generally compiler cannot handle more than one errors or two errors or maximum three errors, and generally one error generate for another 10 errors. So that is a recommended thing. We always tell you in your classes, you check, you correct one error, maybe another four error would gone away. Are you getting my point? The compiler is not so intelligent. So if you are mistaken in one error, then that can generate five more errors. So what we will suggest, we correct that one error, then other five errors will go. Don't try to solve all the five errors the compiler reporting. And warning also, it is better to avoid, not to get warning. Okay, Ankita. So we have already completed the lexical part. And lexical part, what the duty of lexical part? Taken out the comments, taken out the white spaces, and for every key values, we generate the token. And for variable declared, for how to check the variable by regular expression, we have a deterministic finite state machine for checking the variables, integer, floating point, everything, so that the integer variable should start with alphanumeric, not alphanumeric, alphabet like ABCD. And so this can be checked in by the regular expression and DFA. So, and ultimately the token will be generated, and the symbol table will be partially filled up, not fully, because you know the symbol table, what are the other details would come from the parsing. Now we have already top down is easier to understand, because you, whenever in a grammar, if you have, you know, the grammar is one S symbol, S for start. And it start, some grammar is basically, some in books it is V for variables, comma T for terminals, and V union T is your total, you can say, alphabets. Okay, so V is a variable, and ultimately all strings should be consist of terminals, and then S is the starting symbol, and P is the production rules. Now, this S is a starting symbol, means here is the whole program. Okay, remember, all the S is your whole program. Now you this whole program, you have got a string, and now the duty of parsing is you have to reach to S, that is whole program, and from, and you try to elaborate S from the left hand side. So if the string, all string consists of terminals, So if you have a, you see the leftmost terminal, and you try to match what are the production rules from S, matches those. If the more than one rule matches it, then there will not be a proper case of LL1 grammar. I have told you last class for LL1 grammar, the your first of all strings should have intersection, should be shy. So basic restrict basic rule for LL1 grammar is by looking at your left side and by seeing the terminal, you can 1:1 identify which production rule to be used. Why? I have told the last class, because if you go back and again try different rule and match it, that is a parsing. That is a parsing, and maybe that is a successful parsing. But in actual world, we do not allow go backtracking. So backtracking is absolutely no, because last class we have shown we have backtracked only one step. But you know, in a programming language, there were 1,000 rules, and at the maybe a 999, you see you have to backtrack, and you have to backtrack the previous all, and maybe it comes in the fifth stages. So there's a chaos, and program will definitely hang, whatever precautions. So backtracking is absolutely no, but it is a, it can be unambiguous grammar, it can be deterministic context free grammar, but so backtracking cannot be easily removed. Okay, this backtracking grammar, you have to forget about it, though it is a unique grammar, unambiguous grammar, forget about it. Then comes the predictive parsing. The predictive parsing, the great idea is you cannot go back. Okay, so for go back, the two things should be there. No backtracking, that I have told you, no backtracking. And number two, so that by looking at your terminal from the left hand side, you can at once identify the which rule to fire. So then is a problem with the, if is a left recursion is there, say left recursion, I have told you, variable comes at the at your context free grammar left hand side, and right hand side you that particular variable again, that is called left recursion. So for left recursion is absolutely no, because again top down parsing, it will be recursive, and it will you know the problem of recursion, it can go out of when every you try your Python machine. I have found yesterday that I want to calculate, though Python can calculate infinite precision integer, but I try to calculate factorial 999. Python say, particular say Google Python, it say it is out of recursive depth. So every computer has some problem with the how much recursion it can do, because whenever you make a recursion, all the program variables have to be put into a stack, and you know the computer have a multiple programs are running on, and they have a multiple stack. So every stack has given a finite number of memory, so there will be always a problem. So that is one of the reason we cannot have recursive process. Okay, recursion is good if it is a within it. So then the only thing is that you have to no left recursion should be allowed. I'll elaborate on this. Okay, so and then comes the bottom up parsing. That is very interesting. Bottom up parsing logic is we try to from the right hand side, you try to match a production rule so that at the end production rule it will go reach S, that is starting symbol, but you try to reduce it and try to guess that particular production so that you can reach to S. And here you in top down you start from S, and here you want to reach S from the right hand side. Okay, so another beauty of bottom up parsing is if there is a left recursion rule in context free grammar, no issue, absolutely no issue. And if there is a right recursive grammar, absolutely no issue. So that is the bottom up parser is much more general, but it is difficult to understand until and unless we properly understand top down parser. Okay, and the bottom up parsing, another popular name is shift reduced parser, because basically it is reduced the strings and ultimately it goes to S. So, and there are several versions of bottom up parser. So try to go for left recursion rule. Hopefully, let's see. Okay, this is the how we call LL1 grammar. This is, you should remember all this. This is DCL means left to right scan of the input always, and this is leftmost derivation. In LR, this is the rightmost derivation. Okay, and one I have mentioned you, instead of one it can be k, but whenever if k, your parsing table will be huge, so even one will suffice. So definitely LL2 grammar is more powerful than LL1, but that extra thing we doesn't want much. So we are happy with all the computer programming can be done with the LR1 grammar, not LL1. LL1 is less powerful than LR1 because LL1 is a purely top-down parsing. One look ahead. This is leftmost derivation. I have already told you. This is already I have mentioned. Now directly go to his answer. I'll come back. Actually, this diagram is interesting. I finished that question. Here you see it is a total case of deterministic context free grammar. Okay, detailed. Now some of them are ambiguous. It may be your deterministic or non-deterministic. Forget about it. So we have a subset, and you see not all unambiguous grammar can have a. You cannot predict it to LL0 or LL1. See, LL0 with zero look ahead, and if you put only one look ahead, immense power. Though it is not drawn as per the scale, but you can at least give an idea that LL1 is very powerful, and if you take more than this, it's not so powerful. From jump from 0 to 1, a lot of grammar can be detected. Same for LR1. See, LR1, you will hear, it takes care all with the LL1 is a proper subset of LR1. So for all practical purpose, all our programming language grammar, 99% are LR1. Okay, so this is, and LR1 parsing table is huge. So generally you go for LLR1. We'll go to that. Okay, so I'll come to this diagram later. Now go back. This thing, his question, ambiguous, all these things will be. You surely come, do not worry. Yeah, parse tree. Just a minute. This is all you have done. Just, I can go because sometimes it hangs. That is the reason. I am not doing it because I am recording it. We have surely come very near. Directly answer his question. This is okay. Now yes, just a minute. Is there? Yeah, this is, I am coming, yeah, see this is the left recursion. A top down parser cannot have left recursion in a grammar. Formally grammar is left recursive, this is direct left recursive. A comes to here, I am coming to this. Eliminating left recursion is easy, I am giving this example, just a minute. I am taking the house books. See, elimination of left recursion. This text I have taken from the Aho's book. So here, if we have a kind this kind of grammar A to eta alpha, we can easily make it A to another new C symbol beta a dash and a dash to alpha a dash. So we are basically right recursive is coming. We have left recursion, we are converting to right recursion. Right recursion is okay for LL1 person, not left recursion. And incidentally, right recursion is no problem for bottom up person, and right recursion is not a problem from top down person. So any left recursion with changing of rules like this kind of changing, if you have this rule, I take it from the Aho's book, A to A alpha, you can make a put it B alpha. Take another example, like this is very famous grammar. This famous grammar, you know, can you identify? This is called expression grammar, our arithmetic expression, like E to E plus T or expression T to this. So that why I make it T, so that it can be, I can make it E to E plus E forward slash, this is Baka's normal form, this is an alternative, E to E plus E alternative E. But why I have not taken that? Why I introduced T? Because I want to prioritize the star symbol. So if in any expression plus and star is there, I want to do as per our arithmetic convention, star should be there. So that is the reason I incorporated we rule E plus T alternative T, T is the T star F or F. Then the most important is the first bracket F to this or IT. This is typical rule of arithmetic expression, so that we can give importance to star. If you do not importance to star, then we can make it without T also. But the problem of this grammar, you at once can admit, I am taking the example from Aho's book, chapter, it you see figure example 4.8. E comes here, E comes here. So it is, T comes as is a left recursive. So we change the left recursive rule by this technique. Okay, what we do for, you go for E dash and we go for T dash, the same rule is written is here. So what we can see here, we have written the same rule here with the left recursion. So any issue, you can always tell me. Shoham, are you getting? It is Shoham's question, no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Shoham, you try to understand by the rule I have mentioned the earlier way, by incorporating another variable, E dash and T dash, what is the complexity? Here we have how many variables? Our grammar E, T, F, that is the variable E, T, F, and others are terminals, star, forward, so these are terminals, okay. So, because this is left recursive grammar and this is very, very important grammar, in all books they take the example, in Aho's book, this is not a case for, this is unambiguous grammar, but this is not a case for LL1 parsing. For LL1 parsing, you have to change the rule by this. By incorporating two variables, E dash and T dash. Please look at the Aho's book if you find any problem. And the rule is, I have told you, rule is, this is the rule. So, this is just a bit. This is the rule. If you found A to A alpha, you make it A to beta A dash to alpha A dash and epsilon. You see one epsilon comes here. Earlier epsilon is not there. Here epsilon comes here. Okay, A dash to alpha epsilon. So same, you can see it here. See here E dash to epsilon come and T dash to epsilon come. Because E dash and T dash, we are incorporating here to avoid left recursion. To avoid, so that we cannot have the left recursion, yes. Because the left recursion, where here these two rules, the left recursion is there, E, E, T, T. So we have to change it, E to T, T dash, and T to F, T dash to like this. So because I am taking E dash and T dash, they also have an alternative rule like this. Shoham, is something understandable to you?
Yes, sir.
Anybody he has issue? It's good. So let me see how much time. Not much time. Yeah. So that is the this is the way. Why we're removing left recursion? The one dangerous is the no backtracking. Even if without backtracking, left recursion means you recurse, and what is the problem of recursion? In every computer, there are some limits how many recursion can be. Okay, so that is the problem. We do not take, though recursion we always teach you, recursion is interesting, but we also caution you in that recursion should not, you also check recursion. If the recursion you are not check, your program will hang. Okay, due to your, maybe you forgot to check the stop recursive option and when to stop recursion. Then the recursion is very costly process. It takes the huge space of memory on the stack. So that is it. So recursion should not be there. So avoid recursion. We introduce two more symbols here, E dash and T dash, and we modify these rules. We see here we have modified, like it's kind of an infix notation, prefix notation. See, the rule becomes kind of a, one is postfix, one is infix, another prefix. So it's kind of prefix. Okay, prefix rule is okay for computer. And see, there is no recursion is there. Okay, all rules start. So this is now the our chosen rule or for grammar. Now, this is the general rule. If we have a rule like this, A to A alpha, A alpha, so you can, all rule can be changed by A to beta 1, A dash, beta 2, A dash, beta n, and A dash is alpha 1, this, and lastly epsilon. So this is the more general rule for removing left recursion. Now, this is left factoring also. Same thing, if we have this kind of thing, it starts with same, so we have to left factor. It is not possible for top down LL1 person. You can left factor by this way, the same way, or at same thing. Now the one interesting, what I want to come, this is the whole task of the team. This is the parsing table preparation. How to create a parsing table, I'll come. And this is the parsing program. Here the input is your string, and ended with dollar, because at every string end is dollar, and this is the left hand side. So LL1 grammar will try to match this with a rule from parsing table. Your parsing table consists of a, this every terminal that there is a rule, okay, and this is the stack. Okay, everything you put into, initially stack should be empty, and after all everything is there, your this side will be empty, and this is also come to empty. We like it. How to do this, we'll elaborate in our next classes, but just to finish it. So this is after your parsing table. So this is your non-terminal. Remember, this E dash and T dash we are incorporating here to avoid left recursive grammar. And whenever you see ID and left hand side ID, we can see with ID you can get only one this rule. With plus, no such rule, no issue. With your stack contains E and this star, no rule. So there, but there is at only one rule. So this is it, just you see it here. This is a parsing table and this is your stack, and initially it will be here is filled with dollar and S. Initially should be S, and our S means starting symbol. Do not confuse S and dollar. So dollar will be last. This is initially S, and this is the first terminal. So this is the S and your first terminal. You try to match parsing table, what are the entries. Then it is, you got it the entry, then you replace S with those entries here. Then you top side down. Then you also see what is matching is here. Okay, so next class we will do this. Any question, please? I think this one is not clear to you. I think please say frankly. Shoham, সুচিস্মিতা, আর দিয়ার
Yes, sir.
হ্যাঁ, এই জায়গাটা বোঝা যাচ্ছে? এই এই দিস প্লেস?
Yes, sir. ওই মোটামুটি।
হ্যাঁ মোটা, আমি বলতে দেখো শুধু এখানে কি হবে বলে, এখানটা এটা ইন্টারেস্টিং, এই এটা খুব ইন্টারেস্টিং। কে 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 আছো আর? অঙ্কিতা, বুঝতে পারছো? অঙ্কিতা বলো কোন জায়গাটা, কোন জায়গাটা তোমার অসুবিধা হচ্ছে বলো। অঙ্কিতা দাঁড়া, আমি আমি কোথায় গেলাম? ও আমার তো ওইটা চলে গেল। আচ্ছা দাঁড়া, আমি কোন জায়গাটা তোমার, এই যে এই 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 যে প্রেডিক্টিভ পার্সিং, দিস ইজ, সরি Yes, I hopefully it will show it here. Here basically we have to first make, if the first, the whatever first things are all intersection is, all the right hand string first is shy, that means you can have only your input string is here. And that means the first of this A should match with only one variable. You should match it one. Yes. Because it is a top down parsing. The top down parsing at the stack, what should be this? Yes. And you should start S with A. There maybe must be only one and only one rule. Say then S becomes, say, capital A, capital B. Now what should be the thing? B comes here. S goes out, B comes here, A come here, not reverse, B here, A here, then this has taken away, now say there is plus, so now B to plus, whether any matching, we get it to parsing table, same way it matches, if it doesn't matches, give error, otherwise plus is taken away, your pointer comes this way and it will be replaced by this rule, so at ultimately whenever you are getting, this will comes there, finish, okay, and what will be there, dollar will be there, only dollar, that is a top down parser. Any question? And here also you are using the stack. Kajana cho, ba, na 48, question karo anything.